skin rashes like eczema, allergies of various sorts, immune depression, cardiovascular health problems, raising blood pressure, which then in turn causes heart disease and strokes. So all of these things can be attributed to stress. Now the question is, though, what causes people to become stressed? And what is the medical profession, and on a broader level, the political system, doing to reduce the stress levels that people are subjected to, and why people are subjected to stress, or why they feel stressed? And then you can also look, and this is an area that I've done a lot of research or theoretical work, actually, more so than research, is looking at the physiological systems that underlie the development of various problems that are caused by stress. An example, and a simple example, would be looking at why does diabetes get worse with stress, right? Now, most people will accept that people will, with diabetes, will become worse if they are stressed, right? And if you look at the reason, stress causes a raise in cortisol levels, right, which is produced by the adrenal glands. Cortisol causes a raise in blood sugar level. Right. At the same time, stress causes activity of the sympathetic nervous system, which produces adrenaline. Adrenaline causes release of breakdown of glycogen from the liver to increase the blood sugar level again, so that you've got energy to run away or do whatever you have to do when you
fight
or flight. Okay. Now that those are just two of the mechanisms by which you could say, this is the sort of work that I've been doing, is looking at the theoretical reasons as to why, or coming up with models as to how stress causes a whole range of different problems.
Right.
And this is something that I have done some teaching at Swinburne University, mainly, in mind-body medicine. And the question, though, that I raised earlier, or a few moments ago, of what causes stress. Now, we could look at this environment that we're in here, and it is not stressful, right? There are birds in the background. It's not, we're not subject to physical coldness. We're free to spend as much time talking within the limits of
light and the nature, whatever.
Yeah. Now, if at the same time, if we are imprisoned, right, stress comes from the mere imprisonment, because it is an human instinct to require freedom, physical freedom as well as freedom to express yourself. And if people are denied their freedom to express themselves, or denied more in an extreme situation their physical freedom, they become stressed and miserable. Now, the system, and I'm talking about the corporate system that governs the entire economy as well as the political system, is geared towards trying to make people work faster and faster and faster, and to stay up for long periods of time, working throughout the night, in fact, which is, all these things are unhealthy for us. But because it's all about trying to create more speed and more production, and at the same time, the people who are working the fastest and doing the most production are paid slave wages. And at the same time, people, especially in the third world countries, or the developing countries, as they're called, or the poor countries, really, in other words. These people are paid absolute pittances, while the people who are in charge of the boardrooms are paid multi-million dollar salaries. Now, these are the causes of stress, or some of the causes of stress.
So you're saying that finance and the economic model,
yes,
that theory is what this is all about, basically.
Exactly. And with the drug companies, their primary objective and they will admit it, most of them, is to sell their drugs, is to represent their shareholders. Now, if you increase the disease that a particular drug is targeting, increasing the disease either by increasing the number of people with the disease, mm-hmm. or increasing the dose that is recommended, or increasing the duration of treatment that is suggested, or increasing the number of people who are said to have the disease, and then you increase the number of people who go and have tests for the disease, all of these things will increase the profits of the pharmaceutical industry.
And broaden the market.
And broaden the market. Mm-hmm. And the reporter who's done the most work that has actually been published on this would be Ray Moynihan, I believe, who was an ABC reporter who wrote a book called Too Much Medicine back in 1997 or 1998. And he described it as disease mongering. Right? Now, I call it disease creation, whether you call it disease mongering or disease creation. But drawing the point or raising the point that when you're talking about deliberately causing disease in other people, that is effectively the same thing as biological warfare. That's what biological warfare is. And it should be viewed with the same degree of gravity. You know, even if it is medical doctors who are creating the disease, or in fact, especially